Hi DIYers, Sterling with Alarm Grid here. Today we're going to show you how to program a 5834-4EN 4-button wireless key fob. Very similar to the standard 5834-4, the 5834-4EN allows you to arm and disarm your wireless Honeywell security system with a touch of a button. We have four buttons on the fob. We have an arm away, which is our lock symbol. We have our disarm, which is our unlock symbol. The picture of the guy in the home would be our arm stay option. That means our motions are turned off, but our doors, windows, glass breaks are active. And then finally, we have a button number four, which we can select to do any function we would like. It can be a panic alarm, it can be an activation of an automation scene or rule, it can control the 5877 garage door controller. So you have a lot of options for using this button. This key fob is the biggest difference between this and the 5834-4 is it's got the nice glossy finish, and it, more than that, it's got the silver background around the buttons, and we've got the silver on this beveled edge here where our keychain ring is. So mostly it's a look and a feel difference compared to the 5834, the standard one, which is just all black with the matte finish. So if you want a fancier looking key fob, this 5834-4EN is the one you want to get. Now to program it to our Lynx Touch L5200 system, it's very simple. We go to security and then more, and tools. From tools, 4112, which is the default installer code, gets us to this screen where we can enter programming mode. Once we're at programming mode, instead of using the zones programming, which you may be used to for your doors and your windows, this keys section of programming is a shortcut to program the fob, all four buttons together all at once. Much less likely to make a mistake when you do it this way. Add new allows us to put a new fob in. You'll notice we already have an existing fob, which is already set up. That's for our normal 5834-4. So add new allows us to program our second fob. So the first thing we want to do is click into serial number. That allows us to enroll the device. We can type in the serial number on the back. 0401305 and done. And it automatically maps button number one to arm away, button number two to disarm, button number three to arm stay, and button number four says no response. That means this button activation won't do anything. So we're going to leave this in our nightstand, okay? That way, right before we go to bed, we can arm stay. In the morning, we can disarm. And if we ever needed to walk out of the house, we could take it with us and go arm away as well. In the middle of the night, if we ever heard something and we wanted the police to come out right away and we didn't want the person in the home to know we've activated it, we can select that for a 24-hour silent. Now when we press and hold this button, it's going to activate a silent alarm that will send through to the central station, and that central station knows to then call the police immediately because that's how we set it up with them. They can also call the house and verify the alarm first if that's what the customer requires. But the selection here will tell the system how to respond. Audible alarm, silent alarm, or do nothing. The last thing we have to do before we save our settings is to select the user code for the key fob. The key fob, even if the programming is right with the serial number and the button programming, the buttons won't do anything when arming or disarming unless they're mapped to a valid user code in the panel. Our master code is the only code we have set. It's code number 1234, which is the default. And we just want to assign it to the master. When this fob is used to arm or disarm, the panel will respond and will report that it was the master key or the master user that armed and disarmed. Same as if we used our code 1234 on the Lynx Touch panel to arm the system. So again, we have to map this to the master. If this was going to go for our neighbor, we could set up a sub-user code and we could map it to that user, and then that way our neighbor uses a different code. If they use their fob or they use their code, it reports as the neighbor. In our purposes, we just have the one code, so we're going to set it to master. very important that we save our selection. And we can see now zones 144 through 147 are programmed. 144, 145, 146, and 147. If we jump into our zones and we scroll down, we can now see that these four button settings are set up. So we could have gone in here and done it through the zones, but we would have had to know the specific loop number for each button, and we would have had to select all of these entries for each zone. So you can see how much quicker and easier it is to do it with the keys programming. So now that we've programmed our 5834-4EN to our L5200 system, we can show you that it's working. We press and hold the top left button, which is arm away.
Armed away. Exit now.
We have our exit delay, our period where we can leave the home without triggering an alarm. And we can disarm. Top.
Disarmed. Ready to arm.
Top.
Time.
Top right button disarms. And then we can do bottom left for arm stay.
Armed stay. Exit now.
You'll notice in arm stay mode, they still give you the exit countdown. They just don't beep every second to alert you, because they know by arming to stay, some people are in the house. And therefore, some people can still leave. That's why there's still the exit delay. Everybody else that's in the house doesn't have to hear it beeping every second for the exit period. Again, we can disarm, or I want to show you the key, the silent alert. So we're going to disarm.
Armed, stay. Armed, ready to arm.
So we're going to disarm.
Time.
And then now we're going to show you that silent panic alarm. So if we press and hold, you can see it doesn't do any alarm activation audible, but it does show not ready to arm, indicating that the silent alert was triggered and sent through to the central station. This icon also is displayed, so that would be the only visual indication that the alert was sent. No audible alert, but that shows that this silent panic did work. So we disarm again.
Arm. Chime.
We're back to ready to arm. If you notice on this fob,
disarmed, ready to arm.
The LED lights up green when we press our button. That indicates that we're using the standard security mode. On the 5834 series key fobs, there's actually a high security mode where instead of sending the same data every time to the panel, it sends a rolling encrypted message from this device to the panel. You may have heard of that with like garage door remote controls as well, where instead of sending the same sequence of code from here to here, it actually resets and does a rolling code every time, so that if anyone ever somehow spoofed or got the code from your key fob, they could not come in and disarm the system without you knowing about it. So the high security mode, we talk about that in the 5834-4EN programming video for the L7000 panel. And we're gonna do another video that goes in more depth about why you would do high security mode and how to take it from high security to standard mode. But again, if your LED is lighting up green, you're in the standard mode. If it's lighting up red, you're in the high security mode. So that is our 5834-4EN wireless programming video for our Lynx Touch L5200 system. And please subscribe to our channel to be kept up to date with any new videos. And if you have any questions on programming your 5834-4EN, please email us support@alarmgrid.com.